Out of these practices, but catalog is not yet online. It will be, but it's not yet. But we are sharing some of these practices with you today. And next year we are going to take like few practices that each doctoral school tests in their own universities and own environments, and then we are going to have this kind of innovation menu. But that's the future. And this engagement is something we do all the time, like here today, right now.
And the project focuses on something that we call the triple I. And here we mean that the triple I, the first I stands for international, the second one stands for interdisciplinary, and the third I stands for intersectoral. And what we mean with this is the international activities is everything that has to do with foreign students, foreign staff, opening teaching also in other languages, connecting with institutions in different regions, having conferences, organizing events, networking, whatever is that is international. We here want to take that and see how it works in doctoral education and how we promote it, what are, if there's some hindering factors, what can we do about it. The interdisciplinary is the fact where you combine two or more academic disciplines to create something new, and this is kind of like, because the problems we face today are usually not solved only by one academic discipline. You need cooperation, collaboration, and you need to have more disciplines focusing on one single problem, and there might not be always easy to organize. So we try to address this and think about how can we promote interdisciplinarity. And because we are all 9 graduate schools in social sciences and humanities, we do interdisciplinary on a daily basis, but then of course we want to expand to other disciplines too and try to see what can we find of this, and that's why we are here, because I see that this is, for example, we work now with doctoral school in natural sciences here. The intersectoral is a new different approach that increasingly students find jobs outside the academia. But the academia isn't always been very helpful in addressing this issue, how to help the students. So we want to think about intersectoral activities, how to work with other sectors than the academy. And here the goal is that if we provide this triple I initiatives and activities, it works both for us, and it also serves the academic community and society better. I'll tell you something about what we have about the international activities. Here we divided them in our reports. We don't divide it in these kind of stages, but here we thought that it's a good idea to see what kind of activities we have and how they are on different, like, first you have something to start with, and then when you are familiar with this practice, you can go on. So the basic level practice here is travel grants for PhD students, which basically means that we provide, as a doctoral school, money for students to travel to something that promotes their degree. They have conferences or research days or something like that. And this is pretty common practice. Then a good practice that we have is a handbook for international students, promotes their internationality within the doctoral school itself. For example, here we have from Ohio University. They have a practical manual for foreign students, which is made by the students themselves. So the students do maintain the handbook, and it is for kind of like from peer to peer. But the University of Helsinki have an international affairs office, and they have a website where they gather this information. So it can be done on different levels. I can show you the examples after this. We have the sites open, so how does this look like? Okay. Here they have everything from arriving, getting started, traveling, how to basically settle your life in, if you are accepted in this graduate school that is located in Warsaw. So here they have very hands-on kind of examples for the foreign students, how to buy a ticket, like here it is. And this is usually, the advice is not provided, because here is the idea that the students know themselves what kind of information they need, and then they share it with each other. And the graduate school is kind of like the one who says, good idea, we'll help you to do this. The students do it, but the graduate school promotes it. Then when you have, when the internationalization level is pretty high in the graduate school, for example in the Erasmus University of Rotterdam, they have a lot of foreign students, and also they have their own Dutch students with migrant backgrounds, and then they want to that they, all the students feel welcome and connect with each other, that there is no isolation. So they have started up something that they call a diversity project. Here they want to make sure that all students, regardless of their background, be included, and they see in their brochures that all kinds of people are presented in their brochures. They reward people for connecting with each other, and they also provide training and organize events around this area. Like they had a presentation about the Me Too issues in academia, and they have a training for staff about intercultural competence. So this is kind of like when you have a lot of international activities that then you have to think about how to make it work for your graduate school.
Yes, and here you can see examples of interdisciplinary activities if you want to enhance the interdisciplinary element in your doctoral school. And the very basic level is to organize multidisciplinary events that bring from different disciplines together. For example, you can organize seminar series, some kind of annual conferences, workshops, or summer schools. Or you might even consider having a doctoral seminar or course on interdisciplinary issues, because that's for sure something that everyone is interested in. So finding a theme that, that interests many different people, despite their background. And if you want to go even a bit further and you know, support, for example, a PhD research that is interdisciplinary, then you must allow PhD projects that connect different disciplines. And you might even have, but it's a very good idea to have multiple supervisors also who can actually supervise those PhD projects. That the supervisors themselves come, that they come from different disciplines. And if you have, and the recommendation is that you have at least two supervisors or a group of supervisors, then it is very, very good practice to have and make a supervision plan or supervision agreement where you kind of, you make a plan that is supervisor has what kind of role, how often you meet, what happens between the meetings, and how you prepare for the supervisor meetings. And it helps to know what you are expected as the supervisor and what you are expected as a supervisee. So that you share and discuss all these different roles and rights and responsibilities beforehand. So before there might be some kind of problems in supervisory relationship. And here you can see an example from Erasmus University and guidelines that we have here in University of Finland. We are going to send these slides to you afterwards, so you can afterwards go and click all these links. But I'm going to show you one link, and that is kind of related with this advanced level, that if you want to go even a bit further with this interdisciplinary issue, you can create a multidisciplinary doctoral program, so that the doctoral program is not created by the discipline, but the kind of taking the point of view is to have a theme that connects different disciplines, and the example here is our own doctoral program, Gender, Culture and Society, where there are like doctoral candidates from 5 different faculties and supervisors from 5 different faculties. And, this is the doctoral program, and it organizes courses and events for its doctoral candidates, and it has a steering group that consists of professors from each faculty, so the Faculty of Educational Sciences, Faculty of Social Sciences, Faculty of Theology, Faculty of Arts, Faculty of Law. They are all represented in the steering committee, and the steering committee also selects the candidates, the PhD candidates. It reviews their proposals, and it's responsible for planning the curriculum. So it's truly interdisciplinary because all the disciplines are represented in the steering committee. And it's a very good idea also to have to list all the supervisors on the web page. So here you can see all the supervisors that work for different faculties, Faculty of Arts, Educational Sciences, Law, Social Sciences. So these are kind of supervisors they know how to supervise interdisciplinary research projects, and we have the kind of permission that their names are listed on the website, and the PhD candidates can contact them.
And I'd like to say something about the third pie, that is intersectoral, which has probably been the most challenging for us in this project, because traditionally humanities and social sciences, doctoral schools don't have a strong link with the industry, for example. But here, our basic level of practice would be to arrange guest lecturers from outside the academia for a course, or a workshop, or part of the course, some lectures to share their experiences outside academia. Then to take things further, doctoral school can organize transferable skills courses for PhD students that would help their future, possibly outside the academia. These kind of courses can consist of career guidance, company visits, networking skills, communication skills training, etc. I'm going to just quickly show you an example from our partner university, K-Lerman, since they have this nice brochure. I'm just going to show you the contents, because I think this, guidelines. So here you can see, for example, communication and collaboration skills training, research and education skills training, career development, and so on. So doctoral school can organize different types of courses that can help the PhD students to develop their skills outside the academia as well. And then on the advanced level, there's something that has already been a little bit mentioned today about the thesis committee, and that we are implementing it is starting this year. And in our doctoral school, we are going to have a strong recommendation for each PhD students to have a sort of intersectoral mentor as part of the thesis committee, so that there will be someone during your own PhD studies to help you with this kind of intersectoral skills. So that's our last slide, and we're going to leave a few minutes for some possible questions. But there you can find our website, where there will be content available as mentioned, And if you wish, you can also subscribe to our newsletter to get more news and information about the projects. I'm going to hand you these leaflets. Yeah, if you wish to take these to get some basic information about our project as well. And if you have any questions or so, you can ask them now, or we are very pleased if you wish to contact us later as well.
So the best practice catalogue of the 100 practices Kirsi mentioned is probably coming after summer. We get it online and then you can see, and there's some smaller practices listed, and then we have some listed with more in-depth description of how to do these practices.
Thank you. Your presentation is very interesting, and I think that it put this somehow in our mindset, will change some commercial integration. Yes? And my question is about your thought of interdisciplinary learning. So, do you catch somehow transdisciplinary? Because mostly basic, the most innovation idea come from interdisciplinary framework of research.
Yeah, this is, the terminology is quite difficult. Is it about multidisciplinary?
No. Multidisciplinary is quite separated. Transdisciplinary, it meant that you take some knowledge that are not inside any discipline at all. Because something happens, you see this, but there is no theory support for this. So you must, in your investigation, you must find this theoretical support, you must find the theory.
Yeah.
It's so
we have this kind of like a report that made about the best practices and the triple I, and in that in the report they questioned that they use that terminology is sometimes misleading when it's multidisciplinary, when it's interdisciplinary, when it's transdisciplinary, cross-disciplinary, and they are sometimes used a bit overlapping. So we kind of use the term as more like umbrella term that we include in interdisciplinary, also multidisciplinary and transdisciplinary, because sometimes it's hard to say when it is this or that to get whole just purely interdisciplinarity. So we kind of use all the terms just connecting them with interdisciplinarity.
Okay, yeah. So it's not only exclusive logic but also inclusive logic.
Yeah, kind of to have that. We ask our practices about their interdisciplinary like practices, and then we can't really monitor and check like is this truly trans, multi, or interdisciplinary. Let the graduate schools themselves decide what are the good practices they want to share. So we are not really focusing on is the terminology now correct, just to give our good practices.
And PhD learners will always be kind of beyond what it's known already.
Yes, yes,
so to and I think. Go beyond what it's known that we are aiming for. But if it happens, then sometimes it happens, sometimes it doesn't. We hope to create such a research environment where that might happen.
I didn't see any, say, other countries in Europe to work for.
Other countries?
Yes. So maybe just. Yes.
These are
Hungary?
Other countries.
It's Poland. So you mentioned they are from program countries. So for capacity building, probably it's not capacity, probably this is another
type. It's kind of like what we do with the engagement. In engagement, we have.
Because it's
here.
Really very interesting
with EU and the other countries. So from here we do it. So like we are the EU partners, and then we share it with the rest of the world. So that is fine.
Maybe it's the best practice. The name of the program is best practice in EU countries. languages. So you are realized your project within the European Union, not with the limitation of the countries like Russia or however, it's fantastically interesting to have a look at your catalog because it's very implemented for our project. So you are very so we can look at the
Thank you.
Yes, very